Yeah, and also with Wolfie Glick and Barris using the same or the similar teams, they've obviously trained together.
Hello， 大家好啊，咁啊，依家咧就係我哋嘅香港代表啦，Eric 咧就係肖伯，咁啊就依家進身緊世界賽嘅十六強啦。跟住咧，然後咧就佢嘅對手咧就係 Yoshi 啊，非常之出名嘅德國玩家。
希望唔會有回音啦，咁我哋咧現場咧就有其他香港嘅player喺度啦，咁啊包括大家都好熟嘅Hinter啦，咁大家講解下其他嘢啦。咁我就主持中嘅咁我就主持中嘅咁我就主持中嘅咁我就主持中嘅咁我就主持中嘅咁我就主持中嘅咁我就主持中嘅咁我就主持中嘅咁我就主持中嘅咁我就主持中嘅咁我就主持中嘅咁我就主持中嘅咁我就主持中嘅咁我就主持中嘅咁我就主持中嘅咁我就主持中嘅咁我就主持中嘅咁我就主持中嘅咁我就主持中嘅咁我就主持中嘅咁我就主持中嘅咁我就主持中嘅咁我就主持中嘅咁我就主持中嘅咁我就主持中嘅咁我就主持中嘅咁我就主持中嘅咁我就主持中嘅咁我就主持中嘅咁我就主持中嘅咁我
咁係啦，我哋比較新進嘅玩家啦。咁見到阿蕭巴上到 top 16咧，都好開心嘅。咁咧佢係用緊一對雙原始嘅隊伍啦，有呢、這個代獸魔導犬、步榮元同埋月隊嘅。咁佢嘅對手Yoshi 就有呢個概念啦。咁有 Mega 耿鬼，有雷超鋼鐘同埋波波狼嘅。
strategic movement he can make. Marcus's team is really heavily.
咁啊，留意翻 Yoshi 嗰隊咧，其實都喺呢個世界賽上都幾常見啊。咁土豪等等嘅玩家都用同啊。好啦，咁睇翻手法先啦。咁 Yoshi 嗰邊咧就喺一個雷超加呢個 Kyoka 啦，而啊我哋 Eric 嗰邊燒包邊咧就喺呢一個Kyoka 同埋呢一個原
理嘅。咁一開始睇到其實呢個雷超有一個下馬威嘅壓力啦。咁而兩邊都係用 Kyoka 嚟優先發嘅，咁 Kyoka 其實都會俾呢個雷超威脅到啦。咁頭turn如果佢雷超選擇 fake out 嘅話，佢可以蕭巴可以保護啦，但係雷超亦都可以有陽攻呢一招嘅。咁咧如果佢保護人哋讀到佢咧，就會比較有劣勢嘅。
其實咧雷超呢一邊咧咁啊同好多個國飛啊，都同一隊啦，所以佢哋嘅配置都好有機會一樣嘅。咁啊，根據之前幾場嘅直播咯，咁睇翻血量都一樣嚟噶。咁啊，佢就有嘅招數咧，就包括 fake out 啦，呢個大家見到嘅。跟住仲有呢一個腦撞，跟住電擦擦面，同埋最後一招就係復呢個交換，復復交換。好啦，咁啊，依家見到我哋嘅小巴呢邊嘅原始波動咧，咁啊打咗落嗰邊啦。咁啊，因為雷超應該係 AV， 即係突擊背心啦。非常之高嘅得防啊！咁睇落去咧，其實同我哋粵女嗰邊嘅防力都差唔多，睇落去就表面上係啊，亦都觸發咗 Citrus Berry 冇反血啦。咁啊，睇嚟雙方嘅 Kyoka 嗰個調配上咧都係差唔多啊，因為大家見到佢哋嘅血都係嗰啲啊，差唔多咁樣。
咁而家啱啱見到蕭巴都叫做讀到對方會 fake out 落佢只粵女度咁。Kyoka 就趁機去用呢個始源波動啦，咁好彩始源波動打中啦，咁但係雷超仍然剩翻都可多嘅血量啦，咁即係睇得出係呢個突擊背心。咁而家Kyoka 就比較受威脅啦，雷超使用復讀交換都係打向 Cresselia 嘅，咁可能會讀佢保護啦，咁但係冇保護到。而家呢個復讀交換咧，其實俾咗好大空間 Marcus 去選擇啊，究竟想乜嘢去對抗嚟緊黑月女同埋 Kyoka 嘅攻擊？
Maybe he just wants some better positioning. I don't think Hitmontop is a Pokemon you really want to bring out too much here. It's most likely that actually we actually see Hitmontop. So Marcus making me look a little bit silly. Does of course offer some fake out pressure, but can take a big hit here from the opposing Kyogre. I think with the possibly the Gengar on the back, he might take too much damage on that as well. Obviously that stops him from being
crafted. Oh, but 咁啊，依家咧就呢個月女咧讀中咗，咁咧就一個細擊，即係。critical hit 咁啊打咗一滴拍精神超人力嘅波波狼，但系咧只波波狼咧竟然剩翻
波波狼咧次次都剩翻一滴滴血嘅。头先咧 Wolfie 同呢队咧波波狼食咗 Dragon Assassin 都系剩翻一滴血嘅，咁可能呢个调配咧都系比较比较系啦比较调得好嘅咁小巴其实读到对面系会换走嘅，咁但系啱啱好似剩翻一滴血咧，雷超上翻嚟就食咗个打雷啦，始源波动。 就打唔中蓋歐卡，打中咗月女嘅，咁月女下場，而家落翻場，咁而家雷超上翻嚟就再有呢、這個夏馬威嘅壓力啦。
亂收啊！如果啱啱嗰下咧，即係殺到只歐波羅嘅話咧，咁呢下芬達咧就可以處理到一個蓋歐卡，非常之幸運啊！有時
係啊，咁可能各位都聽到我哋都比較激動啦，因為啱啱呢個獨心真係非常之靚嘅。
同埋呢一個真係第一次喺亞太區或者香港區咧，第一次攞到咁高成績嘅玩家啦，咁啊，好值得我哋即係興奮同埋感到同感啊！
係啦，講翻少少背景啦，如果我冇記錯咧，呢、這個今次蕭巴嘅世界賽戰績咧係亞太區歷史上最高啦，之前嗰次係啱啱舊年2015年澳洲嘅搬街，佢係攞到大概頭20几嘅，咁但係冇 top 級到，咁所以香港今次蕭巴今次嘅 finish 係好好嘅，咁而家佢換上咗代秀，兩邊都有呢個 fake out 嘅壓力啊。
好，咁啊兩邊咧都換上咗 fake out 手啦，咁啊都可以做翻一個 fake out 咁。咁最大問題咧，我都係覺得蕭巴嗰邊係唔太容易可以做到分大，咁先分大就喺一個較假嘅 mirror rush 嘅鏡子前入邊咧，係一個非常之大嘅作用啊。而雷超咧就非常之一個大嘅障礙咧，令到蕭巴處理翻對手嘅較假。
咁而家其實啱啱蕭巴向對手展示咗呢個打雷啦，咁俾雷超吸走咗啦。咁其實呢個 Marcus 都可能會有所顧忌啦，可能佢卡會保護或者換走係啦。咁我哋見到蕭巴換走咗卡歐卡，換上咗古拉頓。呢個比較有risk 嘅，因為對面係概念隊啦。咁但係見到卡歐卡，我估係場上最慢，應該肯定慢過雷超先啦。咁雷超冇換走，咁即係阿 Marcus 係冇換上呢個作嘅。
好啦，咁啊，到底雷超會做啲咩咧？咁啊，大家拭目以待啦。咁啊，依下就暫時表面上睇咧，就可以壓制到對手雷超同埋卡歐卡嘅同時間地。好啦，咁啊，代手咧依家都 mega 進化啦。咁啊，會唔會做一個 fake out 或者做其他 damage 都好啦，雷超 fake out 先啦。咁啊，拍咗邊面？拍咗代手嗰邊啦。咁啊，代手就冇辦法喐啦。然後咧，卡歐卡都用咗 origin pulse， 但係因為呢一個中煙之地嘅特性啊嘛，取消翻所有水系招式啦。咁啊，嚟緊呢個 turn 咧，咁睇嚟都我覺得就應該 Yoshi 嗰邊好有機會會換上呢一個阿波羅咧，做一個威嚇啦。咁啊，始終對於攻手嘅代手啦，同埋好大機會攻手嘅巴多嚟講咧，都係一個比較大嘅問題。同埋可以順手換一換嘅天氣，因為始終呢家係晴天啦。咁啊，搞搞會換走嘅機會都非常之大嘅。咁當然可以可能有第二個打法啦，例如換翻烈空座上嚟，等烈空座個無天氣特性咧，取消翻中煙之地無效水系嘅問題，用水招咧攻擊翻對手嘅，即係燒爆嗰邊嘅布拉多啦。咁啊，雷超換走啦。咁啊，正如我所講啦，換上咗呢個阿波羅作個位下啦，基本上送死嘅啫。其實咁啊，同埋 reset 翻啦，雷超下下次出場啦，可以再次用呢個復勾啦。好啦，咁啊，睇下燒爆嗰邊會做啲咩啦。咁啊，歐格首先做一個保護啦。咁啊，睇嚟真係咧，單純想放生呢一個阿波羅嘅啫。咁然後 double HR 成功打翻出嚟啦。咁啊，主要想讀到對手咧，即係 Yoshi 嗰邊咧會換呢個烈空座啦。咁啊，烈空座就冇出到嚟啦。咁啊，得翻個位下手呢個阿波羅啫。然後咧可以睇翻燒爆嘅古拉多就用咗 Eruption。或者都會展露咗佢嘅 setting 翻俾對手知，咁佢有機會係高速特中型嘅波嚟啦。咁呢時候就應該會出翻雷超咧，做翻個復勾之類啦。好啦，應該出翻 Recosta 啦，咁啊，單純想取消翻個天氣啦。
咁頭先咧，大家見到雷超換走嘅時候，可能會諗啊，係咪換呢個烈空座上嚟出水招咧？係其實佢選擇咗換阿波朗上嚟，除咗 intimidate 可以減少咗代秀對蓋歐卡嘅傷害之外咧，亦都令到只烈空座可以無傷上場。咁而家係一個非常之有利嘅位置啦。咁係逼到阿蕭巴而家要換走布拉頓嘅。
換走咗布拉多啦，咁啊上咗呢一個蓋歐卡上嚟啦。
The field setting up primordial you'll see, so water type attacks will be boosted. But actually,
into the delta
here,
so
Mega Rayquaza is going to hit the field roaring into the sky triumphantly.
Really pushing on Marcus into the top 8 now.
So Mega Rayquaza on the field, Delta Stream active.
好啦，天氣變咗呢一個咁樣 Q 氣候啦。咁啊，代受一個 Double H 咁啊，打咗埋去空座嗰邊。咁啊，因為受個奧波龍個 Inimity 嘅影響啦，咁啊威下啦，咁啊降低一級密度，咁啊呢個 Double H 打唔夠 Damage 啊。然後咧咁啊，滑龍電精嘅 Connect 座啦，會到底會打向邊一邊咧？咁啊，對於邊一邊嚟講咧，都係一個重創嚟噶啦。咁啊，打到代受嗰邊啊嘛，代受頂得住咧，咁啊冇機會嘅，基本上。咁啊，然後咧，依家兩隻蓋友卡喺度啦，咁啊，始終蓋友卡大部分除咗芬達之外咧，即係劈女啦，咁其他消息都唔係太傷到蓋友卡啦。咁啊，然後翻呢個時候都算避一避開嘅招原子波動啦。咁都少流咗啲血啦，因為始終可能下下都唔係食到啲咩傷害。好啦，咁啊，最後啦，咁啊，換翻呢個古拉多出嚟咧，咁啊，做翻一個換天氣啦。咁啊，留意翻 Yoshi 嗰邊咧，其實後面仲有一隻類似咁，即係佢仲有呢一個可能咧，可以做翻一個換翻個天氣啦，咁啊搶翻個雨天嗰個天氣啦。
咁因為烈空座 mega 咗啦，咁而家太陽係有效嘅，咁所以對面 call 即係Yoshi 嗰邊嘅水海卡係用到水招啦，咁所以而家燒巴嘅海卡又可以威脅用呢個冷凍光速打向呢個烈空座，所以其實而家燒巴係比較有呢個有利嘅位置。
咁啊留意翻啦，咁啊依家個局勢其實最大可能性咧，可能會將雙方嘅精靈留翻到整翻海卡對海卡噶，而咧就。燒巴嗰邊嘅蓋卡係有軍天雷嘅，所以其實如果處理到呢一個雷超嘅話咧，咁啊之後落嚟嘅 game 咧，其實好有機會贏嘅燒巴，因為睇呢個局勢就要睇燒巴可唔可以保得住佢嘅蓋卡嚟對住對手嘅蓋卡。咁咧依家咧就三隻。嘅天氣始源啊，九十分鐘嘅古拉多同兩隻蓋歐卡啊嘛，再上啦。咁咧呢一 turn 大家都係已經冇退路啦，後面冇剩啦。咁其實咧呢一 turn 咧，重點咧就係睇佢哋三隻嘅分別嘅速度努力值嘅前景啊。因為咧呢個位咧係非常之有影響。邊只首先攻擊先？因為咧首先呢四隻裏面咧最攻嘅一定係嗰只 Mega 烈空座，但係 Mega 烈空座咧，因為佢係一個唔係命玉嚟嘅，所以咧佢打對面嗰兩隻都冇可能係。You can't basically waste the turn at this point because it's so fast paced, and it comes down to I think really the speed. We also know, you know that Kyogre on Edward's side has Thunder, so it does a Thunder knockout Kyogre. Can the Groudon even hit the Rayquaza right now? We don't see any protects. Here we go. Here we go. Top 8 is on the line for these players. This is game 1 though, so still lots to go for. We've got the Dragon Set onto the Kyogre here. Now it's down in the red, so Rayquaza obviously really heavily damaged now. Here's the Thunder. Because it's a big fight.打啦，咁啊成功 connect 咗啦，到底打唔打得先？Yoshi 嗰邊嘅蓋卡啦，咁啊剩翻少少血。好啦，好可惜啊！咁啊，燒巴嗰邊兩隻精靈都仲未死啊，但係呢個時候啦，咁啊處理咗呢一個蓋卡啦。
Onto the Kyogre. Oh no! Kyogre has gone down for Marcus.
好啦，咁啊，依家剩翻咧兩隻原始咧對住咗呢個烈空座，到底咧燒巴仲可以點樣處理到呢一個烈空座？其實仲有一個問題嚟㗎，因為始終呢一個古拉多個招式咧，最後一招咧都未清楚啦。古拉多個最後一招你覺得係乜嘢？
其實我知道佢嗰隊嘅，咁我炮實講佢嗰隻古拉多咧係一個傷火But we don't know Groudon's force attack. Eruption actually won't knock out Rayquaza right now, and Earth Power definitely won't. So you really gotta wonder.
Exactly.
And even if it does have break, the way it happens is if Kyogre gets knocked out, Groudon has to use an attack. So maybe this Groudon doesn't have a way to touch Rayquaza.
This is gonna be interesting. Maybe Marcus has put himself into a good position here, even with Primal Kyogre going down. So both trainers taking their time to think about what they want to do here.
我諗仲有一啲機會嘅，你大家見到呢個 time 已經去到兩分半鐘啦。咁烈空座選擇用呢個神速啦，咁去打向蓋奧卡，蓋奧卡就死咗啦。咁古拉多應該別無選擇，就係要噴火嘅。咁咧係啦，咁噴火睇下打到幾多咁就唔夠殺嘅。其實我覺得咧，燒巴啱啱係有個 misplay 嘅，其實佢可以保護隻蓋奧卡，跟住咧可以再嘥多幾個 turn 咧，咁就可以等嗰場咧係去到。太猛，咁佢係有機會贏嘅。
但係佢睇嚟，燒巴都唔 容易攞到一場咁樣勝利啊嘛，直接係冇保護啊，就陣中時直接擊殺到嘅。
布萊多啦，咁啊
直接進入我哋嘅標飛第二場啦。
The majority of the game, Marcus managed this Kyogre in really well there.
Yeah, I think he looked like maybe he was able to win that one, but that got on ultimately just didn't have any way to really hit that Rayquaza. You know, if a Rayquaza is your best move against Rayquaza, then
you really don't have any firepower there. And you know, there wasn't really any play Edward could have done there either. Like,
我覺得咁樣嘅，因為咧其實我諗大概有三turn啦。咁其實保護一turn之後，佢又要用另一turn去打死只蓋奧卡。咁跟住咧，呢個古拉多用噴火咧係可以令到只夜空座俾自己少血嘅。咁跟住咧，再保護多一turn咧，其實 timer 就完。咁我覺得咁樣係會高，係個 win condition 啦。不過唔好講咁多啦，而家入到呢個第二場啦。咁頭先我哋感覺上呢個控速係一個問題啦，因為大家見到喺後邊呢個對面嘅蓋奧卡快過古拉多，
古拉多係一個好大問題。
Yeah, so I think
you're just
seeing this team play. It's relatively rare that Bronzong Gengar actually make an appearance unless it's against those Groudon Xerneas teams because those teams improve their matchup significantly. So it's really centered around Hitmontop, Raichu, Rayquaza, and Kyogre. And once again, I think Kyogre is really the crux of the team. You know, you get so many Origin Pulse and Water Spouts off because you're well protected. And the reason why it's well protected is because it's bulky. You saw it was able to survive from that thunder with around 44 HP, and it's also able to just you know, take less damage from physical type attacks from Hitmontop's Intimidate, and it also has Raichu to redirect electric type attacks away. So we're gonna get into the second game. That was a really, really close first game, and it really came down to whether Groudon had any other move, you know, other than Eruption to hit Rayquaza. Now that Marcus knows, okay, he doesn't. We're you know, gonna have to see how Edward's gonna adjust.
Gentle, say
a
hi.
He knows he can't play that end game.
We're in the top 16 of the World Championships. We're in Game 2. Give it up for Marcus Stata and Edward Chung of Hong Kong. We're gonna get into this game. We've got Raichu, Cresselia,
This
is gonna be an amazing match.
I'm really excited, and it seems like kind of deja vu here in terms of the lead matchup. So we get the exact same thing basically here. And I would say the early game was probably a little bit more in Edward's favor. We did see that Cresselia has Psychic. A lot of Cresselias in this format forego the Psychic type attack.
用翻同一個方法咧，或者單純喺表面上同一個方法咧，可以俾到對手一個非常之大嘅壓力，因為啱啱對手即
係
過咗第一關，咁啊點樣可以保持到，即係好似啱啱咁樣攞翻優勢咧就好難講，因為始終如果啱啱第一場第一個 turn 優勢係冇一個運氣嘅因素贏咗我哋嘅 Ever 小巴嘅話咧，其實我啱啱第一場已經好輕鬆俾小巴攞咗啦，始終啱啱嗰個。芬蘭打唔到呢個蓋奧卡係好大問題啦。咁啊，雷超首先就一個 fake out 啦，咁啊先打咗落魚女嗰邊啦，咁啊想阻止翻魚女控速啦。咁然後咧，咁啊燒包嗰邊嘅蓋奧卡都係一樣快啲啊，咁啊一個原始波咁打中咗兩邊啦，咁啊冇發生咁多攻擊嘅問題啦。但係由於時呢邊咧咁就用翻個控速啦，咁啊都係打翻我嘅兩邊啦。觸發咗 Citrus Berry， 好啦，去到呢一個槍之後咧，會唔會發生好似上一場？咁就要拭目以待啦。咁啊，到底 Yoshi 呢一次會唔會重施攻擊喺呢個位咧？換上柯波羅，然後燒巴亦都會喺呢個時候攻翻對手啦嘛，攞翻一個相同嘅毒心啊，咁啊精神
聯合超過
同埋啱啱留意翻啱啱個場咧，其實燒巴係喺一個精神聯合殺咗呢個，即係佢變得係柯波羅或者係雷超啦，佢精神殺咗之後咧，就一個分天輪會分落去對手。咁啊，到底月女喺呢個廳會做到啲乜嘢咧？就非常之關鍵啦。咁啊，始終亦都唔可以食到一下嘅攻擊啦。然後一下嘅 ICB 咧，咁啊攻擊翻咗對面啦，咁啊將對手嘅減速嘅速度下降翻啦。咁啊，依家同上場嘅情況咧就完全唔同啦。
Kyogre, the damage onto that is negligent and is already slower than Kyogre and Cresselia, so that basically kind of dead curve from Edward.
Exactly. And so, we're going to see what Edward's going to be able to use that ice cream tool to do. It looked like Groudon was tossing the Kyogre.
Here's Origin Pulse, does it hit Cresselia?
Origin Pulse 都冇 miss 到，咁啊，Yoshi 都好多，咁啊，Pushelia都咁啊，咁啊，咁啊，咁啊，咁啊，咁啊，咁啊，咁啊，咁啊，咁啊，咁啊，咁啊，咁啊，咁啊，咁啊，咁啊，咁啊，咁啊，咁啊，咁啊，咁啊，咁啊，咁啊，咁啊，咁啊，咁啊，咁啊，咁啊，咁啊，咁啊，咁啊，咁啊，咁啊，咁啊，咁啊，咁啊，咁啊，咁啊，咁啊，咁啊，咁啊，咁啊，咁啊，咁啊，咁啊，咁啊，咁啊，咁啊，咁啊，咁啊，咁啊，咁啊，咁啊，咁啊，咁啊，咁啊，咁啊，咁啊，咁啊，咁啊，咁啊，咁啊，咁啊，咁啊，咁啊，咁啊，咁啊，咁啊，咁啊，咁啊，咁啊，咁啊，咁啊，咁啊
see a fake out and maybe just the water slide.
咁大家見到換咗呢個圖圖圈啦，圖圖圈有好多種唔同嘅玩法啦。咁 Marcus 都要諗好多嘅嘢。咁最大威脅當然係黑洞啦。咁但係會唔會係速穿嘅 fake out 咧？又或者佢會唔會保護咧？咁大家見到今次圖圖圈係選擇保護，咁雷超會唔會拍咗落去咧？雷超拍咗落去，咁咧就扣咗一啲啲血嘅。咁裏面嘅 coil 卡係快過Marcus 嘅 coil 卡啦。超完波動成功打中兩隻，咁咧都俾咗一啲傷害隻 coil 卡啦。而雷超係要退場嘅。而 Marcus 嘅 coil 卡咧選擇用呢個噴水，咁咧威力咧應該就比較細啲啦，係啦，因為佢就比較扣得多血啦。而家圖圖圈嘅 Moody 出現啦，防御增加其實冇乜太大影響啦。咁防得亦都冇乜太大影響。咁但係頭先呢個Spiky Shield 咧，令到佢保留咗。如果佢係呢一個一血根嘅話咧，係保留咗一血根嘅。咁係會有一個優勢嘅都，
大家留意翻啦。咁啊 ，Yoshi 呢邊咧對咧最神，即係最煩嘅地方啦，就係好多 fake out 咯。咁啊，雷超退完場之後咧，歐皇台先上場啦。咁佢好明顯帶住 fake out 嚟嘅，咁啊啱啱保護咗嘅隊員。今日聽就難以避免就俾人拍一次啦。咁啊都啊，燒包嗰邊都有機會去換翻嗰個喺圖隊員嗰邊咧就換上呢一個古拉多啦。咁啊，做一個 cancel 翻天氣嘅情況，但係都因為咁樣係好。容易俾人睇穿啊，所以咧好有機會咧會俾對手獨中，所以逃逃犬或者企喺牆度直接硬直一下用一黑洞咧，都係有機會發生噶。好啦，然後 Yoshi 呢一邊咧就喺個卡入邊咧就換咗呢個獨中上嚟喎。咧會發生咩事咧？就一啲神奇啦。咁啊 ，Fake Out 咧亦都 connect 咗啦。咁啊，打到逃逃犬嗰邊。好啦，然後分打啦。咁啊，打中咗落去一個裂空座度，到底會麻痹咧？麻痹打中咗啦！
咁呢度都比較有啲運氣啦。而逃逃犬嘅突防
啦，
係啦，逃逃犬嘅突防上升，速度下降嘅。咁呢個裂空座麻痹咗咧，而家呢個柯波朗又冇呢個 fake out 咧，咁其實咧比較有劣勢嘅呢邊。不過咧，逃逃犬因為裂空座麻痹咗，所以逃逃犬又唔可以將佢瞓咗。咁呢個又係其中一樣嘢啦。
基本上咧，因為對面裂空座依家係確定俾。燒巴隻蓋殼卡係賣嘅，咁意味住啲咩咧？即係燒巴個蓋殼卡咧，只要再出天雷出喺個裂空座個位，無論佢係換中都好，定係企到都好咧，佢都要隔硬食一條天雷，
一隻都係。咁裂空座好保守咁用翻呢個保護啦，咁我哋睇下其他做咩？蓋殼卡呢個動光係打落呢個裂空座度，波波浪快過逃逃犬，但係逃逃犬加防，食到呢個
加防嘅重要性。啱啱個加防絕對係有用啦！哇，然後一個 transfer 到底變咗咩？係兩隻蓋歐卡，問你死未啊？兩隻都識軍天雷嘅蓋歐卡。
Yeah, I mean that's a really, really nice transfer.
咁啊，我側邊嘅朋友睇嚟都冷靜唔到啦，咁我都係繼續我爭住先咪算啦。咁啊，依家咧燒班嘅情況其實都好穩定啦，即係始終柯波羅啱啱用咗只救生拳啦，咁啊講得自己防衞，咁啊依家就唔彈噶啦。咁啊，可以不停咁揾天雷啊、冰光啊、試陣射喺對面咧，基本上都冇乜嘢。當然，如果我係我咧，可能會做一個軍天雷。都係即係亂咁打贏㗎，佢準備到諗定下一場點樣啊？等一後邊燒包變咗一隻古拉多喺度啦，咁啊仲可以黑仔埋，到時後邊最後一隻嘅膠㗎。咁睇嚟 Yoshi 都 What the hell？
係
啦，咁 我哋都要睇下呢個小巴呢個葫蘆裏面買乜嘢藥啦。咁古拉頓咧原子進化變成原子古拉多啦。咁但係因為有呢個 airlock 啦，咁所以呢個天氣其實都係冇天氣嘅。咁李空座用呢個神速打落古拉頓度，成功食咗，跟住蓋奧卡用動哥。
即係簡單講，小巴就話其實我讀中咗你神速搞啲乜，讀我都讀中噶啦。咁我想保住佢，俾你搞佢，咁樣就寧願咁樣讀先。咁啊高蘇明再次 connect 咗啦，咁啊應該冇 damage 啊，都咁啊打咗都其實都唔少嘅。咁啊留意翻條速度拉啦，都係好重要嘅呢樣嘢啊，講多次。咁啊小巴嗰邊嘅搞架咧，其實個速度咧係快過對手嘅搞架，咁啊好有機會咧就轟天雷嘅。但係咧依家咧其實如果外優勢嘅話，有機會咧就會將搞架保護啦，然後更新權咧先撞死只小巴只搞架。咁到底有小巴嗰邊會點樣考慮呢個應對咧？都係拭目以待嘅。
Edwards and protects, or the Kyogre Marcus is in and protects, then Thunder goes into that protect, and him on top just close combats to knocks out the Kyogre. So we're gonna see whether Kyogre protects or not. Edward may want not want to
switch to going on deck and just under your Kyogre and earth power. But of course, this Kyogre 可以換手啦。咁如果 Kyogre 保護，亦都可以擋低任何 damage。但係 him on top 有機會有呢個 feint 嘅。咁唔知會唔會讀到呢個一步啦？咁係啦，全場最快係 Kyogre。咁其實都有啲成算，係小巴用 Kyogre。咁小巴換走咗，換走咗古拉頓。咁但係小巴嘅 Kyogre 都係保護嘅。波波朗用咗陽攻，但係打向呢個葡萄犬，而且葡萄犬唔死，跟住葡萄犬仲俾咗弱視嚟波動。再加呢個特攻嘅Moody 就冇乜用啦。咁但係而家蓋奧卡係肯定快過對面嘅蓋奧卡啦。咁而家會點樣做呢？呢個屠龍又有冇 fake out 可以俾啲壓力其他嘅寵物小精靈咧？
咁啊留意翻啦。咁啊 Yoshi 嗰邊嗰只蓋奧卡其實仲可以好快。所以其實拖開有機會保護啦，我想講，即係頂住先。但係依家可以殺到 Hemon Top， 其實都基本上可以定翻個大局㗎啦。因為你殺埋 Hemon Top， 基本上後邊 Leech Game 得翻隻 Groudon 加加 OK， 都大局。所以如果俾我，可能會集中火力去攻擊只 Hemon Top， 唔係只狗。啱先都有講啦，
就係對面咧，只狗卡咧其實係最快嘅全場，攻擊嘅時段，所以係天雷嚟講。佢係會先制打死只優勢啫。咁啊就咁啊最優先可以攞到呢一個攻擊優勢啦，咁佢就可以先拎到一隻。咁啊後尾咧，佢裏邊定翻只古拉多，古拉多掉出嚟，其實就係天氣就。
I'm really surprised that Edward didn't go for the Thunder onto Marcus Kyogre, because if you do a fake out, then you can make the safe play of fake out into Smeargle or
kick out into the Thunder.85% 啦，大家就拭目以待啦。打到高速，打向古拉頓 ，Earth Power 打落去。都應該係 2K KO 嘅，咁究竟 Ice Beam 會唔會 KO 到呢個血量嘅古拉頓？眼到高速打出嚟，唔死。用呢個比較危險嘅斷崖之劍，但係打中咗，係咪傻嘅條友？小巴成功扳平局數1-1。啱啱都比較有危機啦呢度，咁但係咧成功破解一兩危機嘅。
其實因為咧小巴嗰只鼓咧佢唔係有因為佢唔係好多鬥嘅，所以佢咧驚佢。I really like the people just in there though. I'm surprised I think Kangaskhan and Salamence are still pretty solid both players in this match, especially Salamence against Hitmontop Kyogre with Blaza, but Edward opted to go with a different team composition.
The Griselda 我諗要呢度要講就係其實即係去到呢啲位咧都冇100%會贏嘅 play 嘅。咁頭先即係 take 一啲嘅風險咧，其實都在所難免啦。咁好好彩地85%都冇背叛小巴，佢成功翻嘅。
始終如果啱啱我喺小巴用分打落去，不過都一個有風險啊！呢個始終有機會打唔中。咁啊，第三場就咁大家都睇緊呢條片嘅時候，都會飛咗一段嘅收唔講嘢啦。
It's gonna be Raichu, Hitmontop, Rayquaza, Gengar, Kyogre, and Bronzong. At Edward's team is Kyogre, Smeargle, Salamence, Cresselia, Kangaskhan, and Groudon. Aaron, if you're Marcus, what do you do to win this game? If you're Edward, what do you do to win this game?
I think if
same Pokemon.
I think if you're Marcus, you know your strategy has worked out pretty well. Once again, it was just you got some really unlucky breaks there at the end of the last game. I think also if that Smeargle goes down, I think Origin Pulse missed it. Then Groudon comes back in, and suddenly you're trying to use a 50% accurate Thunder. So Edward kind of gambling at the end there, and it worked out in his favor, especially with that pressure blade over the Earth Power. Since we saw Earth Power did just over the amount it needed, but maybe not wanting to risk a damage roll instead, saying okay, I'll just take the 85%. So Marcus still could have won all of that even despite all the kind of poor luck. But
如果大家有聽嘅話咧，咁其實啱啱蕭巴喺第二場咧，佢好重要就係選擇咗用呢個葡萄犬嚟到代替呢個代獸。咁究竟有冇影響咧？我哋可以睇下呢個第三場，究竟雙方會選擇用乜嘢精靈嚟到先發啦？蕭巴都望一望鏡頭啦。我哋都為你加油啊！好啦，咁呢個 stream 咧上場啦。蕭巴都係選擇用 Crest 同埋 Coil 卡。今次咧Marcus 咧就用2010好 common 嘅 lead 就係呢個 Hitmon Top 同 Coil 卡嘅。咁Hitmon Top 嘅威嚇咧就當然打唔到啲乜啦，除非都冇除非啦。咁即係 Coil。蕭巴嘅 Coil 卡快啲啦，開始次元進卡。
However, in this matchup, maybe doesn't matter.
希望蕭巴
唔好打。但係二用咗佢
咁大，我覺得呢個係陷阱，好單純嘅陷阱，想引蕭巴用呢一個分打打落去，
去搞搞多。
我呢啲基本唔識啊，希望佢唔會發生啦。咁啊，希望
Top
嗰邊嗰個 Fake Out。
One of the reasons why I love the eject button is because it allows you to make plays during the middle, right?
Often, you
can only switch at the beginning of the game, obviously, but what Volt Switch and eject button allow you to do is you kind of make plays based off how that turn is going.
咁大家都會記得 game one 咧，魚女咧係 show 咗呢個psychic 啦。咁嗰陣時咧就 Hitmon Top 剩翻一滴血，咁唔知 Hitmon Top 而家會唔會有顧忌啦 ？Hitmon Top 咧就選擇拍落呢個 Coil 卡度 ，Coil 卡係冇保護啦。但係魚女咧。係用呢個 Thunder Wave 嘅。跟住蕭巴話：我等咗你機會好耐啦，搶搶都係用呢個Thunder Wave。咁跟住咧就呢個 Water Spout 都成功彈翻啦 damage 出嚟。哇！呢次好似抽咗最大亂數喎，同啱啱兩場嘅比咧就因為始終今次搞架冇食到傷害啦。
Kyogre on Edward's end ended up not to go for a protect, and that's mainly because he was probably expecting a fake out onto Cresselia and a water spout, so Edward probably gambling just trying to get some damage off. The Thunder Wave play there is a little bit interesting because at this point Kyogre's already slower, so you don't really need speed control. Maybe Edward realizing though that Kyogre is by far the most important Pokemon on Marcus's team, so by paralyzing it not only has a 75% chance of attacking it, for example, if it got a full paralysis last turn, that would have been so big because then this next turn Marcus can, or Edward just do so much damage. So if I'm Marcus, I'm probably still okay with that because I was able to do so much damage and I didn't take any damage.
We're going to see a switch out from Primal Kyogre on Edward's side of the field.
Here we go. It's going to be that Groudon coming in. So Desolate Land will be active from now on. If there's a big Water Spell or Origin Pulse coming out from Marcus's Kyogre, it will do no damage here. So Cresselia is free to do some big damage to the Hitmontop if it chooses to use Psychic. Yeah, but if it does use Psychic, then the Rayquaza kind of just comes in and Kyogre gets a Water-type attack off. This is a really risky play. We'll see if there are any switch-ups.
Oh! Oh,
the Hitmontop's coming out. Will we see the Rayquaza coming in?
Okay.
Could have been beautiful. It was the Raichu coming in though, so if there's a
psychic
to go onto that.
Oh my god! Really risky. 多 damage 啊嘛，打呢个咧入咗好大 kill range， 然后咧呢一个。
could have been beautiful. It could have been beautiful.
Yeah, I'm trying to understand. Like, he willingly went for the psychic onto the Hitmontop, knowing there was an eject button. So if Hitmontop just didn't swap, I mean, maybe he was really sure Hitmontop would switch out because you don't want to keep the Hitmontop in against.
大概卡又廿五分先至啦。Crowd on，因為大概卡又廿五分先至啦。Crowd 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 on，因為大概卡又廿五分先至啦。Crowd
I think the reason why that's an okay play to me is because Crowd on is probably the best. 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 Crowd on is probably the best.
Icy win.
So Icy win is playing out on from Cresselia. It's going to drop Raichu speed again. So that's two levels of reduced speed for Raichu. One level of reduced speed. no icy wind drops and no paralysis.
Yeah, so no protect coming up from Kyogre there either, which is an interesting decision. You know, that's why it was a really smart Hitmontop switch in, because Fake Out Pressure is just so good. You basically negate one Pokemon from attacking at all. And that was a perfect turn there from Marcus. He's gotten rid of Cresselia and hit the, you know, that Kyogre on Edward's end really hasn't been able to use that much. And we do see Kangaskhan coming, which I do think is maybe the one Pokemon that can really help him out in this matchup. I'm just wondering if it's maybe a little bit too late because his Rayquaza still is sitting at full HP and Kyogre is an extreme speed KO range, especially Rayquaza Mega Evolves.
So Edward decided to go back to Plan A, which is using Game 1. It didn't work out from them. Will it work out from now? Both players are now playing for a position.
同埋呢一家，其中誒，烏龍會唔會降薪？It's gonna be a really big turn.
I think, I mean, Kangaskhan here, even though it's tempting to fake out, not sure you can really afford that. We do see the switch out, which I think is a good play because at least your Kyogre doesn't ping, and it also means you can maybe control the weather a little bit more. Right now, you know, you really have to prioritize knocking out the Rayquaza because it's got all that priority. The other issue is that Hitmontop has access to close combat. So, well, first of all, we're gonna see if the Rayquaza uses the Mega Evolve. Second, we're gonna see if Kangaskhan targets the Hitmontop, and Hitmontop actually stalks out.
Trying to get the intimidation back in again, really reintelligent switch there.
Raichu going down without acting this time.
Yeah,
so I think you're Marcus, so you're fine with that. The Raichu has done its job essentially throughout the course of this game, and now you get a free switch in into whatever you want. Kyogre's not a bad switch in, obviously. You could just bring in Hitmontop, like you said, again, for the Intimidate. So Marcus does have an important decision to make here. If you bring in Kyogre, then obviously Kangaskhan's a huge threat with its Double Edge, but one of the main things is you could switch in Kyogre here and, you know, switch the Hitmontop, but instead Marcus reverses it, brings in Hitmontop, what's that Intimidate off first?
Yeah, so the Hitmontop is in now, gonna intimidate the Kangaskhan and the Groudon, so you see the Precipice Blade, that would do some big damage to Kyogre if it's left unchecked. So Hitmontop also has Fake Out Pressure here as well. So Kangaskhan using Double Edge last turn, wasn't able to get a Fake Out off. You've got a big chance for a Dragon Ascent this turn too.
Yeah, I mean, Hitmontop, you know, threatening with Fake Out, you could also just close combat the Kangaskhan, which could knock it out if not put in extreme speed KO range. So this is big. It's a great intimidate off. The main issue is, you know, you can't knock out the Groudon right now. However, you do know the Groudon's moveset, you do know that it's carrying Earth Power. I'm not sure, I don't expect Earth Power to be able to knock out Hitmontop. Can't do too much of that Kyogre. Precipice Blades also reduce damage. You could choose the, you know, Eruption, but you do have to be aware of the Kyogre switch in or just a Hitmontop Wide Guard. So it's really coming down to the wire. Feels like Marcus has a slight advantage, but it could still go either way. And here we go!
So we're going to see a Mega Evolution coming out from Rayquaza. This is the first time Marcus has chosen to Mega Evolve, and it's been a while since he's kept that airlock going. He's now going to set up the Delta Stream. So Delta Stream going to activate Rayquaza. You're not going to be taking too much damage from Ice type attacks if Kyogre comes back in. We're going to see the Protect on Groudon's end from Edward Chung.
Uh-oh, Marcus looking like he's a little bit... Okay,
don't count that's okay,
but I think he was hoping to pick up some damage onto that Groudon there.
Dragon Ascent?
Yeah,
nice.
So really hoping to get some big damage onto that Groudon to set up for a knockout from Kyogre later on in the game.
Yeah, but time is running out right now, and you have to consider that as a factor, and I think Marcus is ahead in terms of...
但係大家可以留意翻個 battle time 咧，其實剩翻好少嘅啫，三分鐘。咁其實我諗咧，大概係四 turn 啦，四 turn 其實即係要開始注意下究竟即係自己剩翻幾多隻啊，誒剩翻幾多呢個問題。咁即係要 keep 住呢個所有嘅即係定啦。咁即係當然而家最大威脅咧就係 Hitmontop 咧，同時亦都威脅用呢個近身打咧嚟到打成。
Close combat range, but oh, we see a switch out.
We see a switch out from Mega Rayquaza here. The mysterious air current is going to dissipate, and Kyogre is going to come onto the field. Remember, it is paralyzed, so Groudon will be moving forward. And Kyogre will have to be able to handle this.
Double edge
into that. Which slot is it going to be?
Oh, it's Kyogre!
Ooh, that's going to be some big damage there, even with the Intimidate, leaving it just under half HP there. Taking some
lethal
damage for it. Oh! So that's a really good switch from Marcus then. Is this going to be a knockout from Hitmontop? It will.
It is.
So there we go. Kangaskhan has gone down. It's now two Pokemon left on
Edward's side of the field.
Marcus
really big turns. It's so tense, Aaron.
Yeah, I mean, it feels like that might have actually been the game decisive turn. Edward hoping that he stayed in with the Hitmontop and the Rayquaza, right? So he's like, okay, I'm just going to try to get as much damage off as possible, not realizing the Kyogre switching was coming. And it actually could have played very differently. If Edward just double edges the Hitmontop and goes for the air power, then that Hitmontop goes down and then it's Rayquaza, Kyogre, and still three on Edward's end. But, you know, I think Marcus has massively played this game in the sense that he's made really, really good switches. And now we know, you know, it's not over yet, but Groudon is intimidated. It cannot use its fire or ground type attacks. Or it can use its ground type attacks, but, you know, there's a wide guard threat. And timer is running dangerously low.
So we see the Hitmontop coming out. We're going to see Marcus wanting to keep that intimidate later on in the game. So only a couple of turns left. You can only imagine, though, due to the timer. We've got Delta Stream activating once again. So if any ice beams come out into that slot,
Thunder!
It's gonna be going onto that Rayquaza slot. Will it be able to pick up the paralysis as well? So not too much damage there. No paralysis either.
No!
Great switch in there. Origin Pulse is gonna hit both Pokemon. Groudon's gonna go down here.
非常之精彩，臨尾呢兩場即係Yoshi證明咗點解佢係一個世界頂尖嘅玩家，佢嘅操作簡直係無下。頭先先係讀到呢個 Eruption 啦，跟住再換走呢個Hit on top。咁咧係啦，好可惜呢個小巴咧就係十六強。
好啦，咁好多謝小巴再次證明翻我哋香港喺世界上嘅實力啦。 咁啊，我哋都交換簽名啦，其實係簽一份簽。好啦，咁啊，好多謝兩位喺世界賽上面都俾咗一場非常精彩嘅賽事俾我哋睇啦。咁我哋今次呢度暫時嚟呢度啦，咁我哋拜拜。